This project has a lot of benefits to it, and I think you can note that through the diversity of the stakeholder groups that we've got involved with the project. The beauty of the project is that we'll be setting up about 1.5 miles of new river channel, which we can divert water into, allowing for fish and sediment passage to bypass the existing Windy Gap pump plant, reservoir, and dam facility. We started the construction of this project in August of 2022. This last year, we went all the way through Thanksgiving and a little bit beyond. With that, we were able to get out in the field and get started. We had the reservoir down prior to that, so we were able to get a fast start and get most of our embankment in. We're building a new embankment that roughly splits the current reservoir. That embankment has started coming up. We hope this year to complete that embankment. We will bring it up a little bit further, then install a slurry wall as a hydraulic cutoff between the reservoir and the floodplain for the connectivity channel. We'll also be constructing the diversion point, so that'll be a concrete structure with an overflow gate, as well as a fish passage system and gate. This year in 2023, we plan to get out there hopefully in May. We'll see how the snow treats us and then construct all the way through again about that Thanksgiving time frame. At the end of this construction season, we hope to be in a position where we are breaching the existing dam and opening up that Colorado River connectivity channel and allowing water through that, connecting the systems. And then in 2024, we will be back out doing a lot of the floodplain final grading, a little bit of likely some touch up within the connectivity channel itself, creating those riffles, pools, and habitat for various aquatic species. And then we'll also be doing a lot of planting, getting that floodplain established with various species of native plants that we've generally collected on site there and then have grown in nurseries to be ready for the construction of the project. I hope to have things completed in summer of 2024. And then with that, we will likely have a couple years of establishing the floodplain and establishing plants throughout the area. And once we have that set up, the idea is to open that whole area to the public for fishing and recreational activities. This project has a very diverse group of not only funders, but stakeholders from the design side and others. And I believe that's due to really the unique nature of the project in that we're still delivering the water and exercising the water right that is involved with the original Windy Gap project while providing uplift for the local area there and the ecology of both the river as well as the floodplain. So with that, we've got a big group of stakeholders helping to make sure that this project brings all of those different perspectives together to provide the best product we can in the end. We will have that channel set up such that it looks like a natural system, and when we take future generations out there, they won't realize that used to be the bottom of a reservoir.